Okay, hello. Welcome back to the mini rant slash discussions on how I feel about Naruto Storm 4 based on demo footage and such that I've seen at all the cons and NYCC and such. Now, today I'm going to be discussing how I feel on Guy's Awakening. Now, keep in mind here, this is going to be similar to something I talked about before with the Perfect Susanoos. Now, first of all, I'm fine with Guy getting a new awakening. It actually looks awesome, but I have a complaint about it that I'm pretty sure everybody noticed right away. Why is it that when he's done with Awakening that he's basically invulnerable to being hit? Now, I realize that he's fatigued and injured or whatever, and I couldn't tell if he was losing life after the Awakening because it was like a death gate or something, maybe. But I don't see why he would be invulnerable to be hit. It's cool that he can't do anything, but he's invulnerable, and that pretty much wastes time on the clock that you could be trying to get a win. I just saw no purpose to that. So, first of all, I just want to know what everybody would think about that. You know, like, how do they think that's going to affect online? Because I can already think of a few things that's going to annoy the hell out of me with the guy being unable to be touched after an awakening. People could just abuse that to not be able to be hit and waste time on the clock. You'd never know. But now for how I feel about this overall. Why is it that there can be awakenings like this, but they can't update something for older characters that deserve it? Like, I just want everybody in the community to be satisfied and to get something that they deserve. Like, for example, when I talked about the Perfect Susanoos, you know, Shisui hadn't even been in a Susanoo like that originally, so why is it that a character that just got introduced to Revolution can have an update like that, but they can't update, you know, Jugo's Awakening or anything of him? And the same applies for any character that's been around that's had, like, you know, significant changes throughout the anime or the manga. And, you know, this is what CC2 does. They don't care. They just do what they think the fans would enjoy, and by fans, I mean the people that either don't care or just like to abuse Awakenings. And then the fans that really want to see something new end up suffering for it. Now, we're all still going to get the game. I don't want to hear that BS. I'm not getting the game because of that. Because every single person I know that's ever said, I'm not getting the game just because of one thing they saw that they didn't like, they still get the game. Regardless if it's on time or if it's late, everybody gets the game. So I don't want to hear that. But anyways, there's going to be a lot of problems with this. You know, an awakening is supposed to be really strong, yes, but after you're out of it, you're supposed to have a low defense and be able to be punished right away as a result of trying to be in a much stronger state, you know? And instead, they just decide, oh, guy's going to be on the floor and be unable to be touched for like 5 or 6 seconds. And you know damn well, all these people that don't care about, you know, getting good at the game are just going to pick guy and abuse that so they can waste time and try to make things harder for you. Just like it's going to be with the Susanoos. This is what CC2 does to the community. They take 2 steps forward and 1 step back, as I've said before. So, personally, I could see a lot of problems with this. But I want to know what you guys think. What is it about CC2 where they just take things that haven't even been in the game for long and just decide, let's give it a fresh new update, and then all the characters that have been around that have gotten fresh updates, at least in the anime or the manga, don't get crap. That's all they do. Every company does some kind of crap like this, but CC2 is the king, the cherry on the shit sundae when it comes to this crap. They just sit there and take every character that's either new or that nobody... No, it's either a new character or somebody that they want to see something new for in a moveset or an Ultimate Jutsu, but instead they just, you know, either give a new awakening or they just give a character that's brand new that doesn't deserve such a huge update a new update. You know, there are some people that I've seen a lot of complaints about this. And I've been looking on Twitter and seeing all this crap about them caring about their customers. They don't care enough to listen to everybody because everybody wants something different. And with the game being delayed, they have time to do things that we could really want. But instead, they decide to take characters that are brand new from a recent game and just give them a huge update when they didn't deserve it as much as the characters that have been around longer. You know, this is all they do. I mean, we're still going to play it, but in the end, we're all going to be upset about one thing or another, and it's their fault. They don't care. So, I'm not saying that it's stupid or impossible with everybody, because in the end, they do end up doing things that we like. Like, for example, I am excited as hell for Hanabi. She's going to be great. Her ultimate, her combos, they all look fresh and awesome. But, you know, it's just the stuff with updating things that don't deserve to be updated right now. You know, come on, CC2. Kishimoto, update something that deserves it. You know, that's all I'm saying. Take the characters that deserve something fresh that have really changed throughout the anime and manga and give them something new. That's all I'm saying. But anyways, what do you guys think about this? Tell me in the comments below how you feel about Guy's Awakening, and if you agree with what I'm saying, that there should be characters that get updates that didn't get one. You know, ones that have changed in the manga and anime. That's all I want to know. And that's it. So, thanks for listening and everything. See you next time. Peace.